opportunity to introduce myself and our team's policies. My name is Christopher Gordon and I'm the Greens lead candidate in the East Ward. My colleague Edwina Clifton is a family law barrister and she's our lead candidate in the Central Ward. I've been a resident of Gladesville for over 11 years and I'm a small business owner. I am both a manufacturer and a provider of services. I deal and compete in the national and international markets. And while I mostly work alone, there are bursts at the production end where I employ up to 100 people for a number of days at a time. I create product out of nothing. I transform a need into an idea and an idea into substance. I'm a composer by trade, and I write and record music for concerts, for films, and for major events. So I'll throw in a couple of policies. A plague has descended on the city of Ryde. It's spreading all over Sydney, and it began in the offices of the Liberal state government. We've all seen the developments leaping out of the ground in recent months, and without any community infrastructure. Traffic congestion and rat runs, increasing shortage of classrooms, lack of cultural facilities, parkland under threat. Planning should be about people, places, and the environment, not profits for developers and their mates. The Greens have a plan that works for the community and for sustainable growth. On the issue of housing affordability, according to last year's census, 7% of dwellings in Ryde are unoccupied. That's 3,138 empty homes. Greens have a two-part plan. First, an empty homes levy to create an incentive for investors to rent out properties so as to increase the number of homes available for tenants. Our plan is for councils to work in partnership with the state government to place an additional levy on empty homes that have been vacant for 12 months or more, an increase of up to three times the standard rate. If residential rates average around, say, $2,000 per dwelling, this scheme would collect well over $12 million a year for Ryde. And the second part is this revenue raised will be placed in a trust fund that can only be used to build affordable community housing. And the guaranteed income stream from the levy will enable the council to finance new housing projects. And very quickly, Edwina and I will work to make Ryde a solar town and promote community-owned renewable energy, reduce waste and plastic, promote stormwater netting for our bushlands and rivers, and plan to relieve our roads and busways and parkways. We're passionate about making Ryde a vibrant art city.